Hello students, welcome to a new chapter in which we are going to discuss about biomolecules, right? Biomolecules is not that a difficult chapter, but you have to practice the structures in them thoroughly. If you don't practice, if you just draw the structure one or two times, you will not get it properly. You will make mistakes. So what is the best way to practice them? As much as possible. So now from biomolecules, what type of questions you get is structure determination of glucose. It can come for as a long answer, but mostly you will be asked write the cyclic structure of glucose or draw the cyclic structure of fructose. That type of only structures will come for 4 or 2 marks, which is most repeated from this chapter. So now we are going to start about biomolecules. In the name itself, you can separate it to get the meaning, right? Biomolecules. If I take water molecule or ammonia molecule, are they simpler molecules or complex molecules? They are simple molecule. 1 plus 3, only 4 atoms are involved. Same way 2 plus 1, only 3 atoms are involved to make a molecule, right? They are simpler molecules. But biomolecules are the molecules which are having so many atoms in it. They are complex in nature. Complex in nature. And where are they present? They are present in a living body, whether plant body or animal body. What does that mean? The others are not present in plant body or animal body? No. These biomolecules are large sized molecules, complex in nature and present in either plant body or animal body to carry out a specific living process or any physiological process or any process inside the body which is very much important and specific to them only. Others cannot do that process, or other biomolecule cannot do the process of this biomolecule, right? So they are complexed molecules which are present in a living body to carry out an important and specific process inside the body. How, what are the examples of biomolecules we have? If you categorize all the biomolecules, it comes under this category. There are carbohydrates. How many carbohydrates we have? We have so many carbohydrates. Some examples: glucose, fructose, sucrose, maltose, lactose. There are so many carbohydrates, right? All of them are of one category only, which is carbohydrates. Now what is the next category of biomolecules? Proteins. Proteins are made of what? Amino acids. So we will study about amino acids, how they will give rise to proteins. Which amino acids we have? We have glycine, alanine, proline, lysine, isoleucine, so many other. Glycine, alanine, methionine, lysine, so many. Tryptophan, phenyl lactic acid. There are so many amino acids also, right? What is the next biomolecule we have? We have enzymes. Enzyme, acetyl coenzyme A, carboxypeptidase, so many enzymes are also there. That is also a biomolecule, right? Now what is the next biomolecule? Hormones. What are hormones? They are the chemical messengers like estrogen, progesterone, steroid hormones, non-steroidal hormones, so many categories are there. So all of them are also of one category, which is hormones. Now what is the next category? Nucleic acids. Nucleic acids are also biomolecules. They are also having complex nature. How many nucleic acids we have? 2 nucleic acids. One is DNA, other is RNA. Full form of DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA, ribonucleic acid, right? So these are the 2 different nucleic acids. In all these biomolecules, you will see complex structure, and their nature is also specific to them only, right? So what we will do, one by one we will study about carbohydrates, proteins and nucleic acids, because we don't have these 2 now. Okay, now let us study about carbohydrates. What is the similarity of all the carbohydrates? What will every carbohydrate have? You get the name meaning from it that only. Carbo means carbon and hydrate means water. Right? Carbo means carbon, hydrate means water. So basically they are believed that they were believed that the carbohydrates are nothing but hydrates of carbon. So their formula was CnH2O taken n times. This was supposed to be the formula of carbohydrates in which they are hydrates of carbon. Means their formula is CnH2nOn. But all the carbohydrates are not fitting into that category. Example, exception is raminose. What is the formula, general formula of raminose? C6H12O5. Is it fitting into that the formula CnH2nOn? No, it is not fitting. But still it is a carbohydrate. Other exception to the rule is there are some molecules who are having this formula but they are not carbohydrates. We will take an example of acetic acid. Is it a carbohydrate? No. But what is the formula of acetic acid? CH3COOH. CC, right? How many carbons? 2 carbons. How many oxygens? 2 oxygens. How many hydrogens? 4. CnH2nOn. Is it a carbohydrate? No. So the definition was not hydrates of carbon anymore. Then what is the definition? In the carbohydrates, whatever may be the type of carbohydrate, they have carbonyl group. They have carbonyl group and alcohol. Alcohol is nothing but hydroxy groups. Okay. Every carbohydrate have one carbonyl group and many alcohols. Many alcohols are present and one carbonyl. And carbonyl, as we know, can be aldehyde or can be ketone. Some carbohydrate has aldehydic group, another carbohydrate has ketonic group. But alcohols are many. They should be many. And this is only one. So what is the chemical name of all the carbohydrates? Is polyhydroxycarbonyl compounds. Later they are called as polyhydroxycarbonyl compounds. In a single carbohydrate you will have so many alcohol OH groups and one carbonyl group, right? So based on which carbonyl group is present, they are defined into different type of carbohydrates. Suppose if I take glucose, what is the other name of glucose? Is in glucose, what is the formula of glucose? C6H12O6. How many carbons are there? Hexose. It is hexose because it has 6 carbons. What is the carbonyl group in this? Aldehyde. So it is called as aldohexose. Same way if I take fructose, what is the formula of fructose? C6H12O6 only. But in fructose, how many carbons? Hexose only. But in fructose, what is the carbonyl group? Ketone. So what is the other name of fructose? Ketohexose. Which carbonyl group is present? That type of carbohydrate. How many carbons are present? That type of name. 5 carbon means pentose, 6 carbon means hexose, 7 carbon means heptose. Like that, the names are divided. So now what we will see, different types of classifications are present based on their nature, right? Now that let us see the classification of carbohydrates. How many units are present in a single carbohydrate? Based on that, carbohydrates are classified into 3 types. First category is monosaccharide. Second is oligosaccharide. And third category is polysaccharide. Right? Monosaccharide means saccharide here is a sugar unit. And mono means how many sugar units. Right? Monosaccharide means a carbohydrate in which only one sugar unit is present. Therefore, it is called as monosaccharide. Example is glucose, fructose, ribose, all those are fructose, ribose, arabinose, all of them are monosaccharide because in them only one unit is present. Going to the next, oligosaccharide means the carbohydrate in which two or more sugar units are present. The carbohydrate in which a single carbohydrate has two or more than two units joined together to form a long chain. How many minimum? Two, maximum 10. That type of oligosaccharide, that type of carbohydrate is called as oligosaccharide. In them, if you have two units of sugar, it is called as disaccharide, three units of sugar, trisaccharide, and four units of sugar, tetrasaccharide, right? So what is the example of disaccharide? Sucrose. In sucrose, there are two sugar units. What are those two? It has glucose as well as fructose. Is it having two sugar units or not? Yes. Therefore, sucrose comes under which category? Disaccharide, right? So there are so many units in oligosaccharides till 10. If it is having more than 10 sugar units, then it is coming under polysaccharide. Examples of polysaccharide is cellulose and starch. In cellulose, how many units of glucose is present? So many. Same way in starch, how many units of glucose is present? So many units of glucose is present in cellulose as well as starch. So cellulose and starch are the examples of polysaccharide. Now this is the classification. What we will do now is study about first monosaccharide, which is glucose, and second monosaccharide, which is fructose, in detail. Let us start with glucose. First thing what we have to know about glucose is it is having six carbons, right? Six carbon, that means it is hexose. How, with six carbons, what is the structure of glucose? You have to determine. What is that name of the topic called as structure determination of glucose? It has a complex structure, I told. How you got to know that the structure of glucose is only this is by doing some series of reactions based on which we got a conclusion that this is the structure of glucose. That is called as structure determination of glucose. Okay. First reaction is by doing experimental studies, we got to know that the molecular formula of glucose is C6H12O6. This is the molecular formula of glucose. With this molecular formula, what is the structure? You have to give a proof. Okay. So how you can start doing the six carbons can be arranged in this way, or six carbons can be four carbons with two branches, or three carbons with three branches, or five carbon with branches. Anything can be possible, or in the form of cycle or not a cycle. What is the proof that the structure of glucose is determined? For that, what you do is take glucose and do the first reaction in which you heat the glucose for longer time. That means prolonged heating should be done to glucose in the presence of HI. Heating in the presence of HI. If you take glucose, you don't know what is the structure of glucose. So what I am writing here, molecular formula only I have written, and then heated in the presence of HI, what do you got? You got N-hexane as the product. What is the formula of N-hexane? What is the structure of N-hexane? N-hexane means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the structure of N-hexane. If you got N-hexane, that means the product is showing all the 6 carbon atoms in the form of a linear chain, is it? That means even the reactant should also have all the 6 carbon atoms in the form of a linear chain. If the reactant itself don't have 6 carbon atoms in the form of linear chain, How can you get a product with this type of linear chain? It's not possible. Therefore, by looking at the product, we can conclude that therefore, in glucose also, all 6 carbons are linearly arranged. Concluded? Can you conclude this or not? Okay, all the 6 carbons are linearly arranged. So what you have to do? Second step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is the formula? C6H12O6. With these 6 carbons in the form of linearly arranged, what you have to do? You have to do the second step of reaction, in which what you have to do is you have to make the glucose unit. Then what is the next thing? 6 carbons are arranged linearly. What you told in the beginning, that carbohydrate will have one carbonyl group and many alcohols. Where is the carbonyl group? Which type of carbonyl group? And how many alcohols? Where are they? That also you have to prove. So let us find out whether it has a carbonyl group or not by a proof of reaction. So what we will do? We will take that glucose with react with oxime. What is the formula of oxime? NH2OH. Hydroxylamine, not oxime. You get oxime as the product. What is the name? Hydroxylamine. If you take C6H12O6, which is nothing but glucose, and react with NH2OH, what do you get? Is you get oxime as a product. What is the product of oxime? Suppose if I take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? That means first carbon gave NH2. Right? So you got an oxime of this category. If oxime is obtained as the product, that means the compound must have a carbonyl group. What is the proof? Do one more reaction. What do you do here? You react this C6H12O6 with HCN. What do you got? You got cyanohydrine, OH, and CN. Long chain, at the top you got OH and cyanohydrine. If you got cyanohydrine as a product and oxime as a product, those two products will come only for a carbonyl compound. That means glucose should have a carbonyl compound, then only it can give you oxime as one product and cyanohydrine as the other product. Otherwise it is not possible. Okay, you are telling that carbonyl group is present. Where is it present, or which carbonyl group is present? Do the next reaction. What is the next reaction? Take the same C6H12O6 and make it to react with bromine water. If you react glucose with bromine water, it will oxidize the aldehydic group of the glucose into acid and you get gluconic acid. Which acid you get? OH. When you take glucose and react with bromine water, you got gluconic acid, which means aldehyde is converted into acid. What is the role of bromine water? Wherever bromine water is used, it will convert the aldehyde into carboxylic acid. That means if carboxylic acid is coming, that means aldehyde must be there, then only you can have that reaction, otherwise it is not possible. Therefore, an aldehyde is present in glucose, is present in glucose. Is that the proof or not? Yes. If there was no gluconic acid, then you can tell whether it is present or not is doubtful. But looking at the product, you should conclude that aldehyde must be present. Now next what else is present in glucose? Many OH groups I told. What is the proof? Is you take C6H12O6 glucose and do acetylation of the glucose. Acetylation means take acetic anhydride in which what happens is if you do acetylation of glucose you get pentaacetate as a product. How many acetates? You get pentaacetate product. By looking at the product, what can you conclude? That pentaacetate is coming means 5 alcohols was there in the glucose. If pentaacetate was not coming, then you cannot be sure how many glucose is present. 5 alcohols are there, then only you will get pentaacetate, otherwise it is not possible. Therefore glucose, it has 5 OH groups, right? Then only you will get that product. Now next reaction, what is the next reaction? Alcohols are present. Which alcohols are present? How many primary alcohols, how many secondary alcohols? What will you do? You will do the next reaction in which C6H12O6, which is glucose, is reacted with nitric acid and which you get which acid? Saccharic acid. And you take the next acid, which is gluconic acid. Gluconic acid also you take. Gluconic acid also will be oxidized to give saccharic acid, and glucose also will be oxidized to give saccharic acid. What is the structure of gluconic acid? We know the structure of gluconic acid from the top is this: OH, H, OH, OH, and CH2OH. H, OH, H. This is the structure of gluconic acid, which you already know, and we also know the structure of saccharic acid, which is this: COOH, COOH. 1, 2, 3, 4. OH, H, OH, OH. Saccharic acid structure is known to us. Gluconic acid structure is also known to us. If saccharic acid is obtained from gluconic acid as well as glucose, that means they must have resemblance in the structure, right? Which carbonyl? There was a carbonyl compound. You already know that it is there. So that's why gluconic, in the place of COOH, what you do? You take aldehyde group. From the previous reaction, you got the proof or not? Instead of COOH, you take aldehyde, right? And the remaining things is the same, right? What is the remaining thing? Remaining thing is the same: OH, H, OH, OH, right? That means the structure of glucose is having how many alcohols? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 alcohols are present in the glucose. Out of that 5 alcohol, 1 alcohol is primary alcohol at the bottom, which is CH2OH. If the structure is looking like gluconic acid, then only it can show the product like gluconic acid. Therefore, the structure of glucose is this. And that is the linear structure of glucose, having aldehyde as the first carbon and primary alcohol at the last. In between, there are 4 alcohols which are secondary in nature. Now what we will do? We will study the linear structure of glucose, which is either correct or not. Okay?